Okay, I take it everybody has a paper they got coming in the door of the agenda? Yes?
Yep.
Okay. Well, what we're here to do tonight, basically, the fire department needs money. One of the options is to raise taxes. I didn't think it was fair to raise taxes without getting your opinion on the matter. So, basically, we're just open for discussion. Hopefully, we're not gonna have a fist fight or anything. But we're just gonna sit down and talk about ways maybe we can get the fire department some money and explain to you that if we did raise taxes, about what it would be. And I guess take it from there. So, I don't know where we wanna start, but... Yeah, you guys wanna start this as to why we're trying to do this?
Yeah, we can do that.
This endeavor in terms of establishing a fire protection contract with the township started about 3 years ago. Previous to that, Roulette has always provided emergency services pretty much for free outside of donations. As we all know, the state of the economy for the nation has not hit just Harrisburg, Washington, but it's also hit here at home, as I'm sure all of you know. What's happened with Roulette in the last 3 to 4 years? Due to the downturn in the economy, our major fundraiser, which is Bingo has always paid the bills here. The other fundraisers that we've had are barbecues, 200 clubs, ham and turkey raffles. These funds were established to set money aside to replace a fire engine, replace an ambulance, and buy turnout gear and air packs for the firefighters. What's happened to Bingo? We've dropped between 46 and 48% on income for Bingo, which basically means Bingo's not paying the bills anymore. What we've had to do over the last 3 years is reroute the funds that we have obtained from our fundraisers back into the general fund to pay the bills. Once left over, we then sat down with both the fire side and the ambulance side. This is what you can spend. We recently purchased a used engine from a fire department downstate. That engine is basically a carbon copy of engine 46-2, which we purchased brand new in, what, 1997. From 1997 until now, the price of that same truck has gone up $100,000 plus, which means it's jumping an average of $10,000 a year. Now that's not a stock chassis, it's a custom commercial chassis. Similar to the same ones you see PennDOT driving around with the two seats. We do apply for state and federal grants. But also, due to the state of the economy, these grants are getting thinner and thinner as time goes on. Not to mention the competition. Competition is extremely tough in obtaining a grant. That's not to say that the rural areas don't get any, we just don't get as many. Grants are normally awarded based on three different criteria: high population, high hazard, and the number of calls, neither of which do we fit. It doesn't mean that we're giving up. That just means we're not getting the grants we used to, which means we have to take a lot more on the cuff and start doing more for ourselves. Since we started the concept of a fire protection contract, the state allows the municipality to impose up to 3 mils for fire protection. Ultimately, that is our goal. I'm not going to lie to you, I'm not going to try to cover anything up. What we have done is we've sat down with the township and we've tried very, very hard to keep increases to a minimum, but yet get some sort of an increase each year, much as most of you that are working get a pay raise each year. If we... Some of us do, some of us don't. I understand, there's a lot of you on fixed incomes. Okay? We all live here, we all pay the same taxes you do. I'm not saying that to try to alienate anyone or to put us on a pedestal, because it's not. Go out in the street, we are at the same level that you are. We pay the same bills that you do. The difference is, where do we go, what do we do to keep providing the type of emergency services, fire and ambulance, that we can provide for you? Now bear in mind, the equipment that we purchase, we pay the same price as Philadelphia, Pittsburgh, Harrisburg, or anywhere else. We don't get a discount just because we're rural and because we don't have high call volumes, high hazards, or high population. A truck that would cost $134,000 or $234,000 for us is going to cost the same amount in Pittsburgh or Philadelphia. That's the way it is. It's easier for the larger urban areas to come up with the money because they have more tax base to work off. We do not. We know that. Yet we're expected to provide you with the same coverage that Philadelphia could provide, Pittsburgh, or Harrisburg. Bottom line, that's it. As far as the tax increase, I'll let the township officials go into that, but I can say the part of the increase that they're going to ask for in fire taxes is because last year they tried to hold the line down and took part of that out of their general fund. Their finances are in the same position that ours is. It keeps getting thinner and thinner. So basically what they need to do this time, what tax increase they're going to ask for is the raise we're asking for this year and the one from last year that you did not see. That's about all I've got on that one. If anyone has any questions, I'll be free to give you the best answer I can. Yes, sir.
That state 3%, no, that's every year.
The 2%?
The 3 you said the state allows?
Pardon?
The 3 mills that the state allows?
That's a one time.
Once we get the 3 mills, that's it. This millage has been in place for 60 or 70 years. We have never pursued that. We've never had to because our fundraisers have taken care of us and still gave us the capability to provide the level of care that you people deserve. Yes, sir.
How many miles did you put on this fire truck that you had bought? What, is it wore out? Is it shot?
That was my question.
Do you need to upgrade it?
Who mandates that you have to switch fire engines?
There's no mandates that we have.
You guys maintain them well. Why should we?
The one that we just replaced? The one that we bought replaced the what?
The one that we bought replaced the 1967 International.
But we're maintaining a 1970-some ladder truck from downstate because I know a guy that bought it up.
No, that truck is not here.
Well, that's good. I mean, that's...
That truck was sold.
That truck has been gone.
What I was trying to put across... How many miles a year do you put, do you wear a fire truck out in 5 years, 10 years?
To be perfectly honest with you, it's rust that wears them out. It's not necessarily the mileage. The other fire truck, the 1967 International, we got rid of that because the tank rusted out. We couldn't keep water in it. And the way that particular truck was built, we could not pull the body off to replace the tank. There comes a time when you have to weigh your maintenance costs against buying something that you don't have to keep pounding money into, number one. Number two, if we have a piece of equipment that becomes a maintenance issue, that's not doing you any good if it's broke down here.
I could back you 100% for fire protection for my children, grandchildren, or anybody in the township. I would favor a tax increase if it benefits the fire company and the protection of the people.
Thank you.
Let me add one thing to that, sir. It's not miles in town on fire trucks. It's hours. They sit at a, for example, Elliott's. They didn't go anywhere. They sat there 18 hours and ran strong and hard constantly while they fight the fire.
I understand.
So it's not so many miles, it's hours. Time.
I support the fire company 100% and the protection you give. 3 mils may be excessive, but I don't, I know what you're saying about the grant. But, yeah, I can understand it for the protection you give for a small community.
So that you all are aware, they're already receiving 1.25 mils. They're not talking about going from 0 to 3.0.
I understand. So the amount of money that was in the paper, like, is the township giving you $20,000 a year protection for... Isn't that what I read in the paper?
Yeah, it's a little over that right now.
Okay.
How much more are you asking for?
Pardon?
How much more than the $20,000 are you asking for?
The new contract would be in the neighborhood of $25,000.
Plus the $20,000 that you already get?
No, $25,000
total.
We're looking at a quarter mil.
We're asking for a quarter mil increase. The reason they came to you is because that actually is not going to show as a quarter mil on your taxes. It's going to show as a half mil. Because they took last year's quarter mil from the general fund. In other words, they absorbed it. They were trying to work in small steps to keep things going. Anyone else?
The fire protection here, with that does that include the ambulance too? The
ambulance is separate.
Oh, it is?
Yes.
Are they asking for...
We have an ambulance membership drive every year, and the ambulance gets its money from third-party billing. In other words, we bill your insurance company.
Yeah. In other words, this millage on our taxes doesn't include the ambulance?
No, it does not. It does
just
not
the fire company.
Just the fire protection. That's it. Yes, sir.
How much of a hole is the ambulance association in?
We're not in a hole.
Okay.
We're not doing as well as we'd like to be right now, but we're working on it. Yes, sir.
Does fire bill the recipient of services as well?
Pardon?
Does fire protection bill the recipient of its services? Why not?
No, we've never billed for fire calls.
But why not? I mean, you're billing for ambulance. Wouldn't it seem logical to bill for fire as well if insurance covers it anyway? I mean, it seemed to be a source of revenue that hasn't been investigated yet.
We could do that, but that creates another set of circumstances that we would really not rather get into. For instance, do we send you a subscription each year and expect you to pay that? And what do we do for those that don't?
And if they started doing that, they would have to wipe out the fire protection tax completely. You cannot have a fire protection tax and bill. You have to do one or the other.
And what happens then is we have people that don't want to pay that bill. So if their house catches fire, are we supposed to just stand and watch it burn? I'm sorry. None of us want to go down that road. None of us. We would rather deal with the township on the tax issue. They have better ways of getting the money that you're supposed to pay than it would be to put us in the middle and have us try to do that. We're here to provide a service to you. All we're saying is we need help to continue. Yes, ma'am.
I'm sorry, I'm a little confused. At the moment, the Roulette Fire Company is garnering 1.25 mil.
That's correct.
Of the 4 mils that is the municipality, yes, it has to be, it can't be separate, right?
Yes.
At that, so, and you folks are only asking for another 1/4 mil.
That's correct.
For this upcoming year. So that would then put you at 1.5 mils.
That's correct.
Excuse me. So in essence, the 4 mils that's currently in place, if you were to only receive your 1/4 mil, would be 4.25 mils for next year. Is that correct?
No, not for fire protection.
If you already have in place with the township 1.25 mils.
That's correct.
Okay, that's already in place.
I know.
And is that, that's part of the 4 mils that's charged by the township, correct?
Right.
If you go another 1/4 mil for next year, you in essence then, next year's taxes for everybody here would be 4.25 mils.
That's correct.
Yes.
Okay, so, yes.
Is that correct?
You can't retro, you can't back up and charge them for what they did in the last fiscal year.
What we are doing is, last year, they came to us, sorry, last year they came and asked for a 1/4 mil.
Right.
We scrounged and found the money to cover that.
Okay.
This year, they come back and ask for another 1/4 mil.
Right.
We don't have that money this year.
Right.
So we have to raise a 1/2 mil to cover the increase from last year and this year.
Well, what I'm saying, you can't go backwards in collecting taxes and expect them to pay back.
They're not going to pay
from
back.
From last fiscal
no,
year.
No, they're not going to pay back. It's just the township does not have the money to cover that 1/4 mil.
Okay, but that's an important point. In other words, then the township needs that 1/4 mil to cover what they put out last year, but still, in essence, the fire company is only getting 0.25.
Not to cover what we put out last year. We're okay. This is, we covered last year's. What the fire department wants is they want to raise a 1/4 mil each year until they get to their 3 mil.
Right.
Last year, we were able to cover that increase.
Right.
This year, they want another 1/4 mil.
Right.
So now we have to raise, last year, we were able to cover the 1/4 that they asked for.
I understand.
For this year.
For this year. But what it has done is it's brought us up a 1/2 mil. And
but again, my scenario is correct in that you're garnering the money that you put forth last year for the township by increasing that another 1/4 mil. Plus, they're getting their 1/4 mil, so it's a 1/2 mil for this year.
It's a 1/2 mil for this year.
Okay, so it'll be 4.5 mils if everybody gets what they want. Why are you folks thinking that they should increase what they get right now up to the maximum of the 3 mils?
No, we're not asking.
I know you're not asking. I'm saying they are proposing a 3 mil increase that will cover.
They want to get to a 3 mil increase.
Oh, I know
eventually.
They do. But they want to go in increments of like 1/4 mil a year. Is that correct?
Correct, yes.
But my understanding from what was published was that the township supervisors were looking at an overall 3 mil across the board to max them out and begin that now. That's not the case? So you're only talking a 1/2 mil
not
for this year?
Correct.
Okay, well, I think a lot of people are confused about that. I think there are a lot of folks out there that think that you're looking at raising 3 mils.
We knew going to 3 mils was going to be difficult and best for everybody, including us.
Sure.
We knew that.
But at the moment, for this tax year, you're only looking at a 1/2 mil, right?
Total.
Total.
Total, 1/2 mil.
That's a big difference.
4.5.
Yeah, that's a big difference. I think a lot of people are confused about that from what they read.
We never entertained the thought of going straight to 3 mil.
That's
we never entertained that.
Okay, so 1/2 mil. These folks are all looking at 1/2 mil if you go along with this for next year.
Correct.
Which amounts to dollars, very few dollars. How much is your mill worth for your municipality?
A mill is worth $17,000 across the board.
For the population?
For the entire.
Okay, so broken down, these folks who pay, you know, let's say $500 a year, nobody pays that much for municipality down here.
Very few.
Very few. So you're really talking, half a mil being what? I'm sure somebody figured this out on an average.
I gave you an example for residents on Second Street.
Okay.
One mil is the equivalent of $29.30.
All right, so these folks, for a half a mil, they're looking at an increase of like $15, average, $15.
$15, $20, $30.
Okay.
I'll have to say I'm proud of our fire department and volunteers and time they spend. And I think we're just lucky we don't have to pay the firemen.
Amen.
To add to that, what Mr. Gabriel was talking about, we're going from this point forward on trying, on that extra half a mil. No, not trying to recoup what they got last year, because they, like I said, he already covered that, which is from this point forward.
I'm understanding all the thinking. Basically, we're going to go up a quarter mil a year from here on until we hit, well, taxes are going to be 7 mils.
Unless you pay.
Six mils.
They're already at a mil.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. 6 mils.
Largest majority of your tax bill goes to the county, schools. Like I said, when I wrote this up, that gives you a perfect example of a $128 per year real estate tax bill. $99.46 of that's county real estate tax, and $29.36.
We can't hear you.
I'm sorry.
The numbers that I've given you at the top of the agenda there, as an example, just so people understood how millage works and what portion of your tax bill is, or your real estate tax bill is county versus municipal. For this person that pays $128.82 per year in real estate taxes, only $29.36 of that is the municipal taxes. Almost $100 of that goes to the county and has nothing to do with this. It won't be changed, doesn't figure into the percentages for increases. It's only on the municipal real estate taxes.
I guess you're saying right now you're asking for half a mil, and then according to the supervisors, you're going to, your plan is to go up every year a quarter of a mil after that, automatically?
Basically, yes.
Yeah. Until we get to the 3 mil cap.
Until you get to the 3 mils.
Right. Which is only 1.75 mil.
I understand that. But my next question is, the fire department's need for that millage increase each year. I mean, is it there? I mean, how do we arrive at you automatically requiring this much each year?
You wouldn't request it if you didn't need it, would you?
I'm the fire chief here, and this is what we're going for through the grant. There's a FEMA grant out now.
Priority for the grant is ambulance, then it goes to firefighting gear, which we are looking to replace 12 complete air packs with air bottles. Just the pack frame to put the bottle in with the regulator, $6,016 a piece. So you're looking at $72,192 just for the pack frames. The bottles to put in them are $1,320 a piece. With the total, with one spare bottle a piece, is $103,872. Without grant money, without this money, we have to keep building. If we don't get this grant, somewhere this money's got to come from. And 12 new sets of turnout gear for fire protection. That's helmets, gloves, boots, Nomex hoods, and the gear. 12 sets of gear is $22,956. And then radios and pagers. We don't know if the whistle's going to go off. We can't communicate without our pagers, radios. 12 new radios, that's
mobile radios
for in your vehicle, portable radios you hold in your hand, and the pagers for 12 or 15. battery's going dead. $25,600. And see, if we don't get this grant...
That money's gotta come from someplace. And that's what we need this money for, to keep building up the savings, so when we need this one at a time, we'll have to buy it that way, instead of trying to go through the grant.
Ray, isn't it also true that even if you do get the grant, the possibility exists that you may have to match a certain percentage from the existing funds as well?
Yeah, a lot of grants, they paid 100%. And now it's, some of them are 85-15, then it went down to 95-5. And our problem is, if we get $100,000 for a new fire truck, a new fire truck minimum's gonna be $250,000, $250,000. We cannot afford a payment on the other $125,000. See what I'm trying to say? Yeah, we can get a grant, but what good is it gonna do us? We can't afford even a 2% loan payment on $125,000. And that's the problem. Everything is so expensive that now with this township money is helping us greatly. Because everything, we're all our fish fries, chicken barbecue, everything is to pay the gas, the electric, our insurance, part of our insurance, and this and that. So, you know, we're working to pay the bills, not putting any money back for anything. So when something breaks, you know, a rebuild on a pump is about $6,000. So, yes, sir.
How much do you have in your general fund now to run this fire company?
I don't know. He's the treasurer. You'd have to talk to him.
Yeah, there's roughly $20,000 in the general fund. We currently have a CD out right now that's got somewhere between $60,000 and $70,000 in it. The CD has been set up.
The CD was set up as a capital expenditure. When we first took a loan out on this building, we set up what they call a ready excess CD. You can put money in it each week or as many times as you want, but you only allowed 3 withdrawals per quarter. Our building payment was almost $18,000 due once a year. That's where that money came from. What we've done with our fundraisers, extra money we had over and above paying the bills, we tried to put money in this account to set aside for the purchase of an ambulance, a fire truck, or some major repairs on our buildings. That's all that account is used for. We also have a savings account that we try to set up, and that's where a lot of our fundraising money goes to replace the air packs, radios, turnout gear, things of these natures. The air packs that Ray told you about, they only have a life expectancy of 10 to 15 years, and then we have to replace them, because they don't meet standard. These new air packs, the new bottles they come out, when they first come out with them, they were advertised as having a lifetime service. So that suddenly got cut to about 15 years. So every 15 years we have to replace every single one of them. Yes, sir.
Do you really think that this township, as small as it is, warrants a 2012 brand new fire truck that costs $500,000?
No, we'll never pursue that. We would never pursue a truck like that.
Well, your budget seemed to want to build up to it.
No, it's not.
I mean...
The price of a truck, we finished last year with a surplus of $6,000. That's for the entire year. Everything else paid the bills. So any extra money we had, that's what it amounted to. At the cost of a fire truck going up $10,000 a year, not to mention the two ambulances next door, we have to overcome that in order to set money aside to be able to replace stuff that wears out. We can keep buying used equipment, but it's like buying a used car or a used truck. You have no idea the history. You have no idea the issues that it had before, and you're stuck with it.
Well, what's your goal as far as your...